Okay, so what's the workflow for creating a Prezi? Okay, and there it is. It isn't. I think we can all agree that it's not. It's different. So if you're used to something else, it's going to be different. So here's what I see as a workflow, and I would appreciate your insight on this. So I think, to me, that you really do need to think about your map first. And talking with Erla again, we both, when we were putting the presentation together, things started to run together, and you've got too close together. And when they get too close together, when you start to put your path on, you start to see other content. When you're, I'm looking, I want people's eyes to focus on this, but this piece of content is right up against it, and so it actually is showing part of this on the slide that I don't want people to see. So if you think about your map initially and give things more room, then you don't have that as being as big of a problem, okay? Gathering your resources, so your URLs, your old PowerPoint, your any images you have, and again, higher the resolution, the better if you plan to zoom in. If you're just looking for graphics that are just going to complement some of the text, then you're okay. If you're not planning to zoom in on that graphic, it's not a problem. Okay. Then in terms of creating your presentation, they provide several good tutorials, I think, to get you started. And I definitely would watch those as you're going through this. But as we mentioned, you just double-click anywhere in the window to begin going. And then if you want to add more detail, if you've thought about it in terms of I want a large block of text, and then I actually want to zoom in on an image that's associated with that large block of text, you can. I mean, this canvas is really infinite, because even if things are close together, you still can zoom in on something that's smaller. Again, keeping in mind that sometimes when you do that, some of the corners of other things may show up when you zoom in. So the zebra, the primary purpose of the zebra is the changing of the location, moving it around, resizing it, making it bigger or smaller, and then rotating it. But as we saw with Carrie's example, there was also the ability to have a few other functions there, which were some of the layering issues, okay? And for me, I hadn't run into that point yet where I was always waiting till the end to add the frames. And so I was pretty certain that my content was all in the right place. But now that's an issue. So when you have when you add some other components, which we'll do, you'll see that runs into place. You may run into a problem there. Adding images in YouTube videos, the images, we showed how you can insert those. The YouTube video, once you double click on a spot, all you need to do is paste the URL for the YouTube video. Okay, double click on a spot, paste the URL for a YouTube video, and it's there. Okay, that's as simple as it is. And then the framing comes in. Okay, and for the framing, I think at first there were tutorials that were saying, make sure you advanced feature framing, and I was even thinking, okay, that's advanced. We won't even deal with that as part of this workshop. But as you work with it, it's not really an option. The framing, I think, is an essential piece if you're planning to have someone follow a path through. And so I want to. I want to demonstrate how that is going to look for us. And then I think after you've got the framing taken care of, you can add paths, okay? And the reason the framing is important first is you're framing in what you want someone to see, okay? And so if you don't frame it in before you add the paths, you'll probably end up going back later and changing the path because you had to put a frame in order to make it focus in on what you want and not show other unrelated content on the screen, okay? And once you've added the path, then that kind of gives you your so-called story that you can use, and you're ready to click show to present, okay? So I wanted to demonstrate the framing part because I think that's a little bit of a challenge, and then, or it's just something new to see. It's different from, I don't think it's hard, but it's different for people who are used to PowerPoint. And then I want to show how we add the paths, and then I think we still hopefully will have some time where you can just try stuff, and we can, those of us that have used it can walk around and give you some tips if you're running into some issues while you're doing that. You should get some indication on your browser. There should be something scrolling letting you know that it actually acknowledged it. I'd like some kind of an exiting image to come up on the screen or something so I don't click it three or four times. So I'm going to jump back to that new presentation. Okay, I have one item on the screen, and I'm just going to add a few more. So I'm just going to come over. I'm going to edit first, edit my presentation. I'm going to click over here and have some text. More text. I'm not going to take the time to get a YouTube video right now just because I think you can experiment with that. I'll just put even more. I just want you to see the very basics of this. Okay, with those set the way they are, if I go directly to path, and I'm going to actually move this one closer. So if I want to move this one closer to here, what do I need to do to text? Single, one click, right? One click gives me the zebra. I'm moving it closer. And I'm moving it closer, so it's actually going to be worse. I'm wanting to show an exaggerated issue here. So I've got those things listed. Now I'm going to click on path, okay? And I can tell it that I want to add the path. So I'm going to click add path. And I just start with wherever I was going to start with my presentation. So here's my first thing, so I click there. So that becomes one. If this is the second thing in my list, then that becomes two, okay? If over here is the third thing, this becomes three. And if this is the fourth thing, I click on it now, and it becomes four, okay? Now, if I made a mistake, if three really wasn't three, I can drag it off the screen, and it just eliminates that one. So if you, and it just reorders them to the last one, okay? And if it really was supposed to go here, then here, in between each one, there's a midpoint. And I just need to drag that midpoint to the new item. And if I do that, I have a path, okay? Now if we go ahead and actually play this, so to show it, I'm going to come back up to the bubble menu, click on it, click on show, and what's the shortcut for show anytime? Spacebar. But if I click on show now, I'm ready. If I want to go to the very beginning of my show, what do I do? Back arrow. If I click the back arrow and select the all the way back, I start with the beginning. So you can see a little bit of text up here, which could be worse, but it's not too bad. So I'm going to just hit my right arrow, move to the next thing. Right arrow, move to the next thing. Actually, this is working okay. I didn't put them close enough together. And there's even more text. Okay. So my beginning one was the best that I was doing for you on that. But imagine we've got pictures and other things. We've got a list of items that we're showing here. So you know, to eliminate something like this is where the framing comes in, okay? So if I hit the space bar again, I'm out of this. And now, if I just zoom out a bit here so I can see everything, and if I want to frame it, I can click on framing, and I can choose to frame something in. So I'm just going to click and drag a rectangle around this. And if you do that, you'll get kind of a stylized framing that a lot of people like the looks of something like that. So that's, you know, a possibility to do. And you can click on it and move it if it didn't quite center itself. But it's also possible that you don't like, you don't want anything around it. You want it to just, you know, whatever is there to stand on its own. So in that case, there is a hidden frame. So you can click a hidden frame and use that around another item. The frame shows in this view, but when we go to the actual text item, we won't see it. Okay, and I'm going to even on this last one, we'll see what happens if I just frame that part. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to my paths, and I'm going to change all my paths. So I'm taking all of those, and I don't know any other way to do this, else I would if I knew a way to delete all the paths at once. I'm just dragging each one off. So now with the path, I can add it. So I just need to make sure when I'm doing this, you see, if I click here for the first part of my path, I'm going to be highlighting this. I'm going to be selecting what I had before. So, but when I roll over the frame and click that, and now the frame, even though it looks like it's the same thing, the frame is actually being selected. So same thing here. Rolling over it there, rolling over the frame, rolling over the frame. So the proof should be we only see even on that last one. Okay? Hitting the space bar, we should be back to our show mode here. And so if we zoom, I didn't start from the beginning, so it just went to where it was. Goes to the next one, and there it just zoomed in on that last one. So you can put frames within frames.